I'm Kiran Mayi, Assistant Professor in EC Department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I'm going to explain about the modulation techniques. In that modulation technique, I'm going to explain about the pulse code modulation. First, let us see what is modulation. Modulation is the process of varying one or more parameters of the carrier signal in accordance with the instantaneous value of the message signal. Message signal contains the information which we want to change, which we want to send, and the carrier signal which is having no data, but it is a high frequency signal. For the longer distance transmission, we are changing one or more parameters of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal. Let us see how the modulation techniques are classified. Modulation techniques are classified into two types. One is analog modulation. Second one is digital modulation. In analog modulation, again these are classified into pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation, and pulse position modulation. In digital modulation, these are classified into PCM, pulse code modulation, DTCM, digital pulse code modulation. Third one is delta modulation, and fourth one is adaptive delta modulation. In that, I am going to explain about the pulse code modulation. Pulse code modulation is mainly a signal is converting or it is giving the analog signal into binary sequence, means ones or zeros. Means the information analog signal is converted into the binary sequence, that is ones or zeros. Now, if we are going for the pulse code modulation, we are giving the analog signal as an information input signal. Let us suppose this is an analog input. This is an analog. In this analog signal, there is noise is present. Why we are going to digitize this analog signal? There is noise present in the analog signal. This signal is first sampled. Okay, this signal is first sampled into discrete. This is again converted into zeros and I mean binary bits format. This analog is converted into bits format. So this signal is digitized here. 1 1 1 0 0 0 1, like that. So here by means in analog signal there is noise is present. We cannot able to rectify that where is the noise is present. By coming to the digitized signal, if it is a zero, they are having only two ones. Either it is zero or one. Okay, here let us suppose here it may be a signal, one represents high, zero represents low. So in this, if we want to know the noise present in the digital signal, if it is zero means we can take in electrical format, either it is 0 volts, 1 means 5 volts we can see. If it is 5 volts, we are representing the signal with this. So we can here. If there is some noise present, like 1.5, so we can take it as directly 5 volts, right, in the digital signal. So in this format, we are going to digitize the analog signal. Now let us see the pulse code modulation. What the block diagram for the pulse code modulation. For this pulse code modulation, I am giving the analog signal as an input signal. In this input signal, there is information specific. we are going to digitize this analog information to get the pulse code modulated signal. Here in this analog signal is giving to the low pass filter. Low pass filter, which it eliminates, in this low pass filter it eliminates the high frequency components present in the analog signal, input signal, analog input signal. What are the high frequency components present in the analog signal that can be eliminated using the low pass filter to avoid the aliasing effect? This aliasing effect will arise in the sampling technique. We'll see that aliasing effect in the sampling technique. Now, here that filtered signal is given to the sampler. Here in the sampler, it collects the whatever the input signal coming from the low pass filter that is given to the sampler. It is used for collecting the sample data. It collects the sample data and confines the output, confines the input signal. This value here, the sampling rate of that signal, input signal. Here the sampling rate of that signal, input signal, is twice the message signal. It is greater than, in the sampling process, it is greater than or equal to twice the message signal. Here the sampling rate of the message signal is fs is equal to twice the instantaneous value of the message signal. This signal is given to the quantizer. Here in this quantizer, the quantizer is used, collects the sampled output and it reduces the excessive bits. Whatever the excessive bits present in the sampled output, that will be reduced using the quantizer. And also it assigns the voltage levels to the sampled output. And this is giving, it reduces the redundant bits and compresses the value of the sampled output. Here in this, the low pass filter, sampler and the quantizer will be acting as an analog to digital converter. Here A to D converter, you can see. These three in this pulse code modulation will be acting as an analog to digital converter. This digital, this quantized output is given to the encoder. What the encoder will do? It digitizes the analog signal. It digitizes the analog signal. That digitized signal is passed. Actually, in this pulse code modulation, we have three types: transmission path, transmitter, receiver, and the channel. In this channel, the channel is used for transmitting the digitized output to the receiver section. We can see. In this receiver section, decoder will be acting as a demodulator. Here, the digitized output is given to the decoder. Here in this decoder, it reconstructs the original signal. What we can see? In this decoder, we have regenerative circuit. That regenerative circuit will reconstruct the original input signal. Means original analog signal we can see. This reconstructed signal is passing through the destination low pass filter. Low pass filter, which is used for removing or eliminating the high frequency components present in the reconstructed signal, that is giving to the destination. This is the destination which we are we get the reconstructed original information will be gathered at the destination signal. And now, what are the applications of the pulse code modulation? Now, let us see. Pulse code modulation, we are giving the analog signal. So, this analog signal, whatever the noise present in this analog signal, will be digitized like zeros. Either ones means this is binary sequence, you can say. Either it is 0 or 1. means in the to avoid the noise present in the analog signal, we are converting that analog format into digital signal, means by into bit format. We can say bit format means either it is 0 or 1. Either 0 means low and 1 means high. This is the output signal, digitized output. Here in this pulse mode modulation, we are having the three sections. One is transmitter section, channel which is used for transmitting the transmission information to the receiver section. Channel means we can say it as a media. This is used for transmitting the information, digitized output. It is the encoder which is used for digitizing the analog signal. This digitized output signal is passing through the channel. In this regenerator will be available. Regenerator repeater will be available. In through this channel, the signal digitized output is given to the decoder. What is mean by decoder? Decoder will be acting as a demodulator, we can say. What does the demodulator will do? It reconstructs the original signal which we have given as an input. In the source, we have given the analog signal. This we can say it as a source. From the source, I am giving the analog signal. This analog signal will be reconstructed using the decoder. Means it reconstructs the original signal. Reconstructs the original signal. This reconstructed original signal containing some amount of fluctuations or some amount of high frequency components, or that we can say it as a noise present in the reconstructed signal. That noise and the noise and high frequency components will be eliminated by the low pass filter. What does the low pass filter will do? Low pass filter will eliminate. Low pass filter eliminates the high frequency components. To eliminate the high frequency components to avoid the aliasing present in the reconstructed signal. That will be giving to the, that noise eliminated signal will be presented at the destination part. This is the destination part. This is the overall pulse mode modulation. Now let us see the applications of pulse mode modulation. We will use this pulse mode modulation in telephone systems. We can use in telephone systems, in voicemails also we can use this pulse mode modulation. In CD lasers also we can use pulse mode modulation. In and also in digital videos also we can use pulse mode modulation. These are the applications of the pulse mode modulation. So let us continue. In digital videos also we can use pulse mode modulation. What does the telephone system use? In telephone systems, pulse mode modulation will be used. Like we are giving the inputs to the telephone system. Like we are giving, if you want to give a mobile number, if you want to connect to the other station, we have to give the mobile number. We have to press the mobile number. In that, we are giving the input as a binary. Means we are pressing the some amount of 1, 2, 3. So it will convert this into digital format. That digital format means bit format. That will be given as an input. In this type of information will be used in the telephone system as a pulse mode modulator. In voicemails, voicemails means we use whatever the signal we are giving, that will be converted into the bit format. In serial lasers also we can use, and also in digital videos also we can use this pulse mode modulator. Thank you very much.